that I love to think about whenever I'm working with a director, which is, and this is from a mid-career when he was really, you know, before he kind of lost some interest. He would talk about the necessity to spiritually marry your director, that you needed, that you were an instrument of their imagination, you know. And so for me, it's a great value to work with all different kinds of directors. From, I mean, Alejandro Amenábar is very different than Alfonso Cuarón, or Alfonso Cuarón is very different from Sidney Lumet. I felt to be able to be in front of Sidney's camera in his imagination, in the way that he worked. I mean, hell, Sidney Lumet got to direct Marlon Brando. I mean, so to touch that lineage and to touch where he came from, live television, a generation that's before mine, at the same time to work with people of my generation, and now probably in the next part of my life I'll work with a lot of people younger than me. It's how I keep my imagination alive and curious, and it's how I learn. So that's the most valuable part of my life that you're talking about, my creative life. And in regards to 80 and stuff, you know, the only thing, I learned a great lesson from The Explorers, which was when we were making The Explorers, it was supposed to be a giant hit. If they made a movie cost like $30 million in 1984, and people thought it was going to be a sensation. And I don't think it played a complete weekend. Nobody liked that movie, and it was an absolute disaster. It was a great lesson for me as a 13, 14-year-old, first getting exposed to the film business, because it was a trial by fire, so to speak. Because if you can't handle the failure of this business, you're never going to be able to handle the successes of it. And it's kind of a way to find out what your aim is, you know, if your aim is true. And it took me years to recover from that. I mean, it took me years before I auditioned for another movie. I felt so singed by the fire. But I'm very grateful for it now. And I think it's absolutely hysterical that people like the movie now. They're talking about doing a remake of the movie, and I find it absolutely fascinating. If you live long enough, people like anything.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Buenos días.